Konnichiwa, Mina. And now it's time for another game of the 2016 PFA Playoffs. Well, as we take a look at the playoff bracket, as we saw an incredible comeback Chicago had against Baltimore, and then we saw Washington absolutely destroy Birmingham last night. So today's game, first up, would be Los Angeles going to Omaha, and whoever wins, if Omaha wins, they will host Washington, but if Los Angeles wins, they'll be at Washington. This is a National Conference title. But then after that will be San Diego going to Pittsburgh, and whoever wins that goes to Chicago. I can't wait for these two games today, so let's go out to Omaha. It is the coldest game in PFA history right now. It's 28 degrees as the 4th seeded Los Angeles Angels go visit the number one ranked, number one seeded, and number one team in the league, Omaha Thunder, with the number one offense in the league. Let's see how Los Angeles does, because I think this is the first time they played each other too in the season, because they didn't play each other all during the season. And I wonder how Los Angeles will do in that freezing cold that they're not used to being in Los Angeles. And man, remember, Omaha struggled early to end the year. They were 1-3 to final four games a year. They better bring in all they have to have any shot to beat Los Angeles. Whoever wins will play Washington for the National Conference title. So let's get this game underway. Los Angeles got the ball to start the game, and they did a 27-yard return to start Los Angeles' 31. And they slowly march downfield, and then finally at Omaha's 18 on 1st and 10, they throw an 18-yard touchdown pass, and after the kick was good, Los Angeles took a 7-0 lead to start the game. With that quick touchdown, Los Angeles was down. They got the kickoff back, but they didn't return it. Starting at their 20, they made it all the way downfield thanks to a 41-yard pass by Marchie Marvin. They made it all the way down to the Los Angeles 2 before finally completing a 2-yard touchdown pass to tie the game up. So after that, Los Angeles got the ball back, and thanks to a 33-yard return, they start off at their 39. And then thanks to a 32-yard pass, they made it to the Omaha 23. And in the next play, they threw a 23-yard pass to get another touchdown. And after the point is good, they're up by 7. But then on the next two plays later, after Omaha got the ball back, Archie Marvin threw an interception. And the next play, Los Angeles threw another 26-yard touchdown to be up 21-7 to end the first quarter. So, Omaha's in trouble, looks like. And on their first drive, they went third and out. So Los Angeles got the ball back. They went third and out, too. And on the next play, Omaha marched all the way downfield to the Los Angeles 6. However, their Los Angeles defense stiffened really hard, and they couldn't do anything. So they went for the 23-yard field goal, which was good. So with that, Los Angeles got the ball back, starting at their 17. And thanks to a 24-yard pass, they made it all the way to the 41 of their territory. Then they made it all the way down to the Omaha 33, looking like possibly to go get another touchdown. However, their quarterback threw an interception at Omaha returned for no gains to start their 27. And thanks to a 37-yard pass, they made all the way down to the Los Angeles 36 and made all the way down to the Los Angeles 4 before they suffered two straight sacks in a row to be forced to go for a 30-yard field goal, which was good, and end the half with Los Angeles leading 21-13. Omaha got the ball to start the third quarter. However, they didn't get made only to the Los Angeles 45 before they had to punt the ball. Los Angeles got the ball. They made it to their 46 before they had to punt the ball. Then Omaha got the ball, and they made all the way to the Omaha 45, managing to avoid a fumble that they recovered. Then they had a 55-yard pass and got a touchdown, and they went for the extra point. So now they're only down by one. After that, Los Angeles got the ball. Starting at their 31, they made it all the way down to the Los Angeles, Omaha 21 before they stalled, so they went for the 34-yard field goal, which was good, and Omaha got the ball back, which went into the fourth quarter, with Los Angeles still leading by four. So Omaha went third and out as we went into the fourth quarter, and they punted the ball back. Los Angeles got the ball, and after suffering a 7-yard sack, they punted the ball back. It was a good return, which set up Omaha deep in Los Angeles territory. And then after a 44-yard pass, Omaha got a touchdown to take their first lead in the game. However, it would not be for long, as on the next play, Los Angeles returned a 93-yard kickoff return for a touchdown to take a 31-27 lead. Wow, could Los Angeles actually pull off the upset? But Omaha got the ball back and got a 40-yard return to set up at Los Angeles 46. However, due to a penalty, And not that stingy Los Angeles defense, they had to punt the ball back. So Los Angeles got the ball back. However, they went further now as well, so they had to punt the ball back. So Omaha got the ball starting at their 37 with just a 6 minutes to go. And they marched all the way down to the Los Angeles 30. And with just 3 minutes left, they've got a 30-yard touchdown to take the lead 34-31. Los Angeles then got the ball and a 23-yard return to start their 27. They made it all the way to their Los Angeles 40. However, they on 4th and 10, they for an incomplete pass to turn the ball over. Omaha got the ball back to run out the clock to win 34-31. What an incredible game that was. Let's take a look at the final stats as Los Angeles quarterback Maurice Green was 18 of 26, 232 yards, 3 touchdowns and a pick. That would be costly because they might have gone for a touchdown or even a field goal. Might have gone into overtime and maybe won it. And Omaha's quarterback Archie Marvin was 20 of 32, 322 yards, 4 touchdowns and a pick. Los Angeles running back John Fox, 21 attempts, 105 yards, and that kickoff return that saved Los Angeles for just a little bit longer. Omaha's wide receiver Steve Carmona, 5 receptions, 114 yards, and 2 touchdowns. And Los Angeles linebackers Julius Searcy had 11 tackles and 1 sack, and Herman Montes had 10 tackles. What a great game Los Angeles had. They fought really, really, really hard, but just was not enough to stop Omaha. So as we now look at the playoff bracket, it's set that the national conference game will be Washington hosting going to Omaha, and Chicago is going to host either Pittsburgh or San Diego, which is going to be the next game, the final divisional playoff game later today. San Diego visiting Pittsburgh, and whoever wins visits Chicago. I can't wait for that, and I can't wait for the conference championships as we get closer and closer to PFA Bowl 1 in Baltimore. So see you then for San Diego at Pittsburgh.